Hey YouTube, thanks for coming to our channel. This is a beast of a video, and I was unsure how to edit it, so I ended up just throwing everything up as we filmed it chronologically. So it's a bit out of order. The tour of the hotel is kind of at the very end of the video. The room tour itself is kind of at the beginning. And then our adventures are everywhere in between. We go to the Palm. We go for a Thanksgiving dinner meal at the Hard Rock. And then everything else we did. So it's all scattered. And to help guide you through this video, if you want to skip around and cherry pick, we're going to go ahead and timestamp it and mark where everything is in the description of the video to help you out if you just want to watch certain portions. So with further ado, let's get to the action and start the video. And thanks for watching the channel.
And we're pulling up to our destination for a few nights. It is Thanksgiving Day. It's also Adrian's birthday. We decided that we were going to stay at Sapphire Falls for the holiday weekend and to celebrate his birthday. So we're pulling up now. I'm gonna pop out, try to do an early check-in. It's about 2 o'clock, so let's see if we can get in our room.
All right, well, we have about 2 hours to kill before our room's ready, at least hopefully. So we're on the second level of the self-parking lot at Sapphire Falls, and across the way is, you can just see Cabana Bay there on the right. The tower is, I'm not sure if that's Aventura, that might be, no, that's one of the towers for Cabana Bay. So that whole complex is Cabana Bay. And then you can see kind of the rooftops of Volcano Bay, the waterslide park. That's where the shuttle buses would drop you off if you park to come for the day. For Volcano Bay, you park in the main parking lot and the shuttle drops you off over here. But it's a little chilly today, so we think they're closed. There's no water running. And then across the road here is Universal's Endless Summer Resorts, and is that it? Just Endless Summer?
Dockside, maybe?
Dockside and Endless Summer. And then a bunch of other hotels, but those are the big
Dockside and Surfside.
That sounds right. Yeah. Which would be the more budget friendly hotels. Cabana Bay is also budget friendly, but you wouldn't know it by staying there. If you go to our channel, we did a great review about our stay there. We had a fantastic time and we're hoping to repeat that here at Sapphire Falls. So let's go check out the grounds this time with our dog, Molly.
Hello YouTube, we are at the Sapphire Falls Resort, a Lowe's Hotel, in room 2334. Let's go have a look. Ah, here we are. So, if you've ever seen any of my room tours or hotel tours, you know that I don't waste time opening cupboards and looking for blankets. I go straight to the view. And I'll grant you, I wouldn't say this is like a view heavy hotel, but we do have a pretty good one here. This is the lagoon view. The tree's kind of in the way here, but that's the boat dock right there through the foliage. The main lobby is right here. So not a bad view. And then the park's over there. You can see the Royal Pacific Hotel from here. We snagged this view by luck. We do have our dog Molly with us, and normally at Lowe's Hotel, they make you stay on the first floor, but with some pleading, because we had asked for a higher floor, when we called the reservations line, they said that would be fine. They went ahead and gave us a third floor view, so we'll take it. We'll take that victory. So, yeah, the view will work. There's no balconies here at this hotel, so it's hard to enjoy your view even if you have a great one, but like I said, I'll take this. This is fantastic. Now, the room, I'm loving it. It's very beachy, very Caribbean. Obviously, it meets the theme. Nice, comfortable furniture. I'm not seeing a lot of wear and tear here. I love the artwork. Talk about a view. That's a view. Nice working desk. They have in-room dining all day, and it's a thick menu. So if that's important to you, Lowe's hooks you up. I don't believe a king bed was an option. Two queen beds is all they have. But look, I love the beachy pillows. It's just fun. It's festive. There's USB plugins if that's important to you. It is to us. Plenty of lighting. I think this is a 47-inch TV. The air conditioning is blasting. I've got it set to 65. I like the carpet to tile transition here when you walk in. A nice single vanity, too, would be great, but again, I'm not going to complain. And then there is a sliding door here for privacy. And I'll say this, I've been watching a lot of reviews, and I know there are rooms here that have a tub for the shower. I'm kind of a shower snob, so I'm thrilled that we got the walk-in shower. No rain head, but good shower head. Have not tested the water pressure yet, obviously, so I'll do that in a little bit. Water pressure is very important to me. I've been known to unscrew the shower head and take off the water governor to get a better water flow. So if you stay in a room behind me, you're welcome. Plenty of closet space. They do have everything you need, an iron, a hairdryer, extra pillows and sheets. We've already hung up some of our clothing. There's a safe here, obviously. And then, you know what, a mini fridge. I'm sure there's one, but I haven't identified it yet. Let's see. More drawers underneath here. Let's see. Ah, ding, 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 ding. There is a mini fridge, which is important. Because we bought a couple of 12 packs, so we'll be filling this bad boy up in just a little bit. So, yeah, I mean, there's not a lot to it. It is a beautiful room. We're thrilled to stay here. We're here for 3 nights. It will not look this good again. That's why we do these room tours, basically, as soon as we open the door. Because this place will be trash, especially with Molly staying here with us. So, again, I love the artwork. Very beachy, very fun. Thrilled to be calling this place home for the next few days. Let's check out that view one more time. Start and finish. Again, that's the lobby over here, the boat dock, the strong water rum tavern. We'll be going there in a little bit. And there's one of the water taxis coming in. So it'll be fun to watch them come in and out all day. All right, well, that'll do it for the room tour. We'll be doing the rest of the hotel tour somewhere in this video. You may have already seen it or may come after this. I don't know. What's up, YouTube? So we just got off the water taxi right here from City Walk. You have to reference Sapphire Falls to City Walk and then City Walk to here. But we've arrived at our destination. It looks like a museum in like Balboa Park in San Diego, doesn't it? But it is in fact the Hard Rock Hotel and Resort, where we have come for some Thanksgiving dinner at the kitchen. We've heard it's pretty awesome. It's a buffet, so we're gonna go check it out. Let's go find this place. And here we are at the kitchen. We found it. It's basically right when you walk in off the boat. It's like one of the first things you run into, so it couldn't be more convenient. There's indoor and outdoor seating. We chose indoor to be closer to the buffet, so I think that'll pay off.
We are just awesome. I could use help getting out. You look starving, yeah. Don't ask that question, yeah. This is my only view. You call beautiful people dropped off as I know things are coming home. Thank you.
that missing piece is found.
Good. How are you saying it, Vickers? Alright, here we go. Trip one to the buffet. I got some celery, some oversized shrimp. I got all the meats. I got the ham, the turkey, and the, what else is he, what were they having for the meat?
Prime rib.
Prime rib. This awesome mac and cheese. Amber went with some sushi, the shrimp are divine. Mac and cheese, and you got some turkey.
Yep.
Yum. Round one. Oh, we will show the buffet shortly. But you gotta have some drinks while you're at Thanksgiving. So I got the, it's called Give the People What They Want. And it's just, I don't even know what's in it. Blackberry, vodka.
So there's vodka, Chambord, lemon, raspberry, and soda.
Soda, oh yeah, it's so delicious. Good. And then Amber got an old fashioned. And she does. So happy Thanksgiving, everybody. So for round two, loaded up on a ton more meat. All three again, and cornbread stuffing. That's all this plate has, man. Back to Thanksgiving basics. Plate number three is all about the sides, y'all. I got some sweet corn, some more of the cornbread stuffing. I got some baked rigatoni. You know I grabbed one of those chicken tenders from the kids' table. And some sweet potato, yeah. Amber got some mashed potatoes. Mac and cheese, which is the bomb. What is that? Brussels sprouts?
Beans? Yeah, these are bourbon glazed Brussels sprouts and that's cream corn.
All right, happy Thanksgiving. So clearly I'm overwhelmed. The dessert bar at the kitchen buffet for Thanksgiving is ridiculous. I showed it in the video elsewhere. There's full footage of it. There's so many things. This is just a fraction of what they had. That's the cherry cake, chocolate chip cookie. I got a cheesecake back here. I think that's gingerbread the neighbors know for, a pumpkin cookie, a red velvet cookie. And, yeah, jelly beans, so let's dig in. This is gonna close out the night, I think. Some apple pie, some creme brulee, some chocolate cake in the form of a muffin, M&M cookie, and pumpkin pie. And again, this is, I'd say, maybe a third. If you combine it with the other plate I had, a third of what they have over there total. It's the most insane dessert bar ever. You have to love how, like, hip and cool you feel at the Hard Rock Hotel. I mean, that's the vibe they're going for, right? But, you know, the lobby is, like, awesome, but not completely overstated. But they got their tree up. And I think it looks pretty good.
I mean, it's not going to win the biggest lobby hotel tree, but it fills its space completely. And I think it looks pretty good. This kind of has shining vibes, doesn't it? This whole relaxation room? Yeah, I feel like I'm... Where's Jack?
They also have cool memorabilia like this. It's kind of like the restaurants, but Amber has assured me this is a production actual dress, i.e. she really wore it. So I just feel skeptical of that, but if it's true, it's pretty cool. And this set of pajamas apparently was worn by Elvis himself. Again, I'm skeptical, but Amber assures me that that's accurate. They've got dozens of these, so that's the other reason I'm skeptical. There are dozens and dozens of outfits in this hotel. I'm just highlighting some of the top ones. And we just took the water taxi back, again, from City Walk. So we left the Hard Rock Hotel, took the water taxi to City Walk, had to get off that boat, and then on the boat to our hotel. So that's just how it works. There's no hotel-to-hotel transportation. But look at that night, it's so pretty. There's like a waterfall over here. Up here is the Strong Water Tavern, the Rum Bar. That's the top of the main lobby up there. Beautiful. The other thing I love about this hotel is, look at this dramatic re-entry after you've ridden the boat. How awesome is this room? That's where we came in. And then this is where the main restaurant is. Anatista, where you can get breakfast, but right now they're doing a buffet. So they do have these like 7 foot, 8 foot tall Christmas trees all over the place. Look how good the lobby is all lit up at night. But, and by the way, Stormwater Tavern, Strongwater, not Stormwater, Strongwater Tavern gets very busy at night. There's a line, but they have a much bigger Christmas tree here. And it overlooks the lagoon side of the property. It is just lovely. The 49ers game is on. They're up 24-3. Go Niners. And that is the big stone staircase that goes down to the bottom floor. The restaurants and the pool floor and the water taxi. And this is reception over here. So sorry for the glare, but heading back to our room and got a good look at the pool, what the pool's like at night. It is freezing outside. It's probably close to 60 degrees, maybe 59 degrees, and there's still at least one child in the pool, and therefore the lifeguards are still on duty. But yeah, it looks really pretty at night. I'm looking forward to coming in here in the next couple days. Nothing makes you feel better than coming home to this little girl, though, where you're so, hello. Hi, sweetheart. I missed you, too. We made her a bed on here. A bed on the bed. And she's able to access it via the armchair. Hey, little girl, how you doing?
Ah, good morning, Universal. Day two here. Last night was a hit. We had a great time. Dinner in the kitchen at Hard Rock Cafe with the turkey buffet for Thanksgiving was amazing. Very, very filling. Oh, here comes the boat. To take people off to a day, a fun-filled day of adventure at one of the two parks. I'd say the highlight last night was for sure dinner. And then the other thing was, while we think it was a little overpriced, the, not Stormwater. Honey, what's the bar called again?
Strongwater.
Strongwater. I keep messing that up. Strongwater Tavern. Super cool theming, super cool place, the best staff ever. We think the drinks were a little underpowered, especially for the price. But we had a lovely time talking to a British couple
who lives on the East Coast, but she was from Manchester, big fan of Manchester, so let's shout out to Manchester. I don't think I've ever talked about it, but my parents are both from the UK, so we had a lovely time speaking to them. And yeah, then dinner. So it was a pretty mellow night, but today I have no idea what we're doing today. Right now we're just going to have some breakfast. I'm going to dig into that cinnamon roll and then hang out with Molly for a little bit, our dog, and let's see where the day takes us.
First morning in Sapphire Falls, we took Molly out for a quick potty break, and then we ran over to New Dutch Trading Company. It's in the lobby, kind of to the right of where the check-in desks are, and we grabbed some orange juice. Adrian grabbed a sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit. I got a bacon, egg, and cheese croissant, and Adrian saw this cinnamon roll and just couldn't resist. That thing is huge. Can't wait to try this breakfast. The shop was very busy, but it was pretty quick.
All right, talk about a lazy Friday. I hope nobody's killing themselves on a Black Friday sale deal right now. We are chilling out. And our first stop of the day, after a lovely boat ride over here, is the Twosome Chocolate Emporium, where one of our favorite bars is on the second floor right there. That's what those windows are looking at it. And we're going to go with some old fashions and some delightful food. So join us inside.
Well, we made it to the bar at Twosome's, and there's surprisingly some spots available. It's about 2 in the afternoon. Look, it feels like fall. It's kind of raining outside. It's a gray day. It's cold for Orlando. But yeah, there's the other end of the bar. But I had my usual old-fashioned here, but I had switched it up based on the recommendation from the bartender. What is this called again, Amber?
So this is the vanilla chocolate cocktail. It has Madagascar vanilla vodka, Trader Vic's dark chocolate, Ferretti chocolate, and chocolate bitters.
This looks delicious. Let's just give it a try.
So we're out in front of Island His Adventure. We just came through the ticket booth, and there are decorations up. I'd say more understated than Disney, but still very nice. And I think it would probably look great when the sun goes down. So we'll try and capture that too. Well, let's go through the arches and see what else they have up.
So once you get past the front gates of Islands of Adventure, the Christmas decor is kind of scarce. If you come over by the Hulk and all the superhero stuff. So that's a little disappointing. Wrong. There are some holiday decorations within the storefront. We're in comics. Look how cute. Nice purple tree. Good comic merch. And all the good places. But it is actually decorated for the holidays. Are we getting this? Here's another tree within the comic store. Looks so good. And I see Hawkeye on there. I saw Spider-Man on the other side. Mystery. I think that's Ant-Man. Got some Hulk. Venom up there. Okay, so fun tip. On a cold day, you can stop into the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, grab a hot butter beer and a double shot of whiskey. Husband went to go grab his. I paid for it. At Universal, it's one drink per ID, so he had to go grab his. But gonna warm us up. Awesome.
Halloween's Eve is one of my absolute favorite stores in Universal Islands of Adventure. Bride of Frankenstein, looking very festive. She's fantastic. It's hard not to love this place.
I like it. They did a good job. Yeah. What shop is this called, Amber?
It's normally the All Hallows Eve shop. I know it changes seasonally, but it still does have that
Halloween
spin.
Yeah. Well, lots of cool old school traditional monster stuff. I cannot wait for Monsters Land to open in the new Epic Universe theme park. This is easily one of our favorite stores.
A very festive Frankenstein. I love him. I mean, particularly, look at that. What is that? Mistletoe that he's wrapped in? I feel like that's right.
I think it is mistletoe. He wants to give you a kiss.
He looks fantastic. Little known fact. I am a Falkenstein like originally. Falkenstein's pretty dope. I wish they would have kept my name. Oh, Frankenstein, I love you.
Well, Mary Mary's just landing didn't skip for the Christmas decorations. They kind of have to, given the whole Grinchmas thing. But yeah, looking good. We're just on the outside of the land, so I'm going to head in and see what else they got.
Magical trees. They're right outside of Dr. Seuss Landing Holiday. It's beautifully decorated for the season. So we woke up and came down for a quick breakfast snack, and they're doing this U.S. Hunger event in the lobby of Sapphire Falls. It's so cool. It's all these volunteers packaging boxes. I think it said 270,000 boxes for children. It's I think it's food. It's such a cool event. So we decided to hit the spa and pool today. It's a little warmer than it's been, so we were in the hot tub for a few. Then we popped over here to the seating area right outside the drum club. They've got an awesome fire pit, some seating, great view of the pool. The hot tub's back there, right behind Mr. McD, and then the drum club. They do have service out here, so we just grabbed a couple more drinks and a snack. It's a beautiful day.
Yeah, it really is nice out here. There is the hot tub that Amber pointed out. It would be nice if it was adults only. There should be a law against having kids in a hot tub. I understand it's Universal Studios, so. The pool here is huge. It's the biggest resort pool of all of them. And there's a DJ out here. I don't know where she's based, but she's been coming in between songs. And then when it gets really busy on the other side, there is another bar that they open up on the really busy days, but this is not one of them, blessed be. But yeah, the drum club is probably the best themed pool bar I've seen in a while. There's about seven seats in there at the bar with a couple of televisions and a friendly staff. So, and it's conveniently located. Last night we were down here in the hot tub, so it's just three steps to keep going to getting our pina coladas, which is what we were primarily drinking last night, in about 50 degree weather. It was absolutely beautiful.
Well, isn't this sweet? Unprompted, completely unprompted. Our server arranged for us to get some dessert churros with some Nutella and some, I don't know, caramel, what is that? And these are delicious. So, yeah, what a sweetheart. She was great. The service from the bartenders and the servers here has been spectacular, top-notch. Like the Opal Sands, actually. It's certainly on par with that.
Well, it's night number three, our final night here. Partying is always such sweet sorrow, but you can see the Christmas tree there in the back of the lobby of the Sapphire Falls. There is a side door we've been using. We come from the third floor down to the first floor and come through here, but I love it. There's all these meandering paths that literally go nowhere. They're just to views, so you can take in the lagoon and the waterfall and the foliage. This path does eventually lead to the swimming pool, but there's branches of it that go nowhere. This goes nowhere. And there's the lagoon out there. It's getting dark. There is no boat at the dock currently, but you haven't had to wait that long. One or two boats max. It's been busy, but we're gonna miss this path. This is where we've been bringing Molly every night. So here's the side of the part of the hotel that looks out to the lagoon, and our room is up here somewhere. It's one of these. But yeah, there's this nice little path. The only people we've really seen on it have been other dog walkers, so very friendly types. People have been pretty good about cleaning their dog waste up, I have to say. There's not too much. And there's all these little areas of grass here that you can go to. And it goes for quite a ways, but it's just a really pretty little walk. And it has not been a chore. I mean, look at the landscaping. It's beautiful and thick. And the hotel frames it out. And you can hear the waterfall running. And it's just been a wonderful time. We had a great moment earlier today. I think we got some footage of it, but we ran into a family of ducks. They weren't quite babies. They were probably, I don't know, teenage ducks. But they came up, I think it was right here, and interacted with Molly. She got a kick out of it. It was a nice, sweet encounter. But yeah, you can see what you're doing. And then these paths go into staircases. Maybe you'd rather just take a staircase. We prefer to take the elevator because we're on the third floor. But they do make this accessible. I almost wish there was some benches out here. There's beautiful wife. Hi, Amber.
Hey.
She's walking Molly. Let's get eyes on Molly. Where is she? There she is. She has had a grand old time at this hotel. And speaking of the devil, look, there is a boat coming in to pick people up. So that's about every 15 minutes or so. But yeah, if you bring a dog to this hotel, you're in for a good time. I would highly recommend it, considering the price of hiring a dog walker or going to a kennel. And then spending time with them in a beautiful resort like this. It's a travesty we couldn't take her into the pool, but I don't know, we'll take what we can get. So here again, you can see some of the theming of the hotel. The tree is up there. The main water feature is on the other side of that. But look at, I love the lighting on the rocks. And then here's the side door that we've been coming in to take us up. The elevator bank is right through this door, and it shoots you up to wherever you are in the hotel. The other thing I love about this is there's not a lot of artwork going on in these hallways, but I love these lanterns. It feels very, it's got a kind of a Pirates of the Caribbean vibe, which is appropriate because this is supposed to be a Caribbean
inspired hotel yet, but yeah, they run down the whole length of the hall, and I like it. They just really add to the mood here.
Stopping off at the Velvet Bar before our reservation at the Palm. Such a quaint and cozy little bar. Have live music from 8 to 11 p.m. every night, and they're open until 2 a.m., so it's a good spot. So we stopped off at the Velvet Bar inside the Hard Rock before our reservation at the Palm. Adrian got this American Pie cocktail on the left. It's an old fashioned featuring rattlesnake, rosies, apple pie whiskey, anga rooster, I never say that right, the bitters, and brown sugar. Mine is on the right, and it's a paper flames. It's noble oak bourbon, Aperol, Amaro, Montenegro, lemon, and pecan syrup. These are both really fantastic. Adrian's, the bartender said Adrian's was like full on a glass, and he was right. It's a little overpowering, actually.
Yeah, but tasty.
And here we are at the Palm Restaurant.
Best part of this video is coming right up. There it is. Honey, are you gonna sign the wall? Because you're the celebrity here. Well, I didn't realize Amber had alerted the restaurant, the Palm, that it was my birthday, but she did, and they just brought this over, so I have no idea what it is. But the fact that they would just take the time to do that, I love it.
So we both ordered the Always in Fashion. It's a bullet bourbon with Grand Marnier, maple syrup, cherry bitters, black cherry, and orange peel. This is a very fantastic old fashioned.
All right, the first appetizer has arrived. It's a meatball. Amber, what do we got here?
Special blend of ground veal, pork, and beef with Munster cheese and marinara.
And some bread here on the side. This looks delicious.
So we got the lobster bisque, and Adrian's gonna pour half into the bowl. Looks fantastic.
Dinner has arrived. I got the 22-ounce center cut
bone-in
ribeye. That's right. Highly recommended. We got some hash browns and some mac and cheese.
That's hash browns.
Oh, my bad. What did you get?
I got the shrimp saute.
This looks amazing. Bon appetit. This basically melts in your mouth. It is delicious. The flavor is divine. And for dessert, unfortunately, I have blown out the candle for my birthday wish. But I got the New York cheesecake with bourbon caramel sauce, I believe, on the side. So this is just delicious. We're going to dig in. The steak was amazing. The sides are amazing. We'll definitely be back at the Palm. So there's a really cool bar here at the Palm too that you can hang out in. And then a nice big
lobby area. You check in right here. And then the Rain restaurant is down there. But yeah, I'll come back. This looks like a really cozy place to have a cocktail. Just when we got here, our seats were ready, so we went ahead and sat down. So I didn't get a chance to sit here, but next time. This hotel's really good at having these massive panoramic views of just everything. So here's the pool late at night, 37 minutes after closing, in all its glory. Nice quiet evening on our final night. We're sad to see this place go, but we'll be back.
Go for our last morning potty.
Go. We'll just extend the trip by another week.
Let's do it.
Molly's paying for it.
With her cuteness. Here's our last daytime walk of the pet area at Sapphire Falls. It's actually very nice. It's a little balmy on this Sunday morning, but just thought we would give y'all one more look at the grounds for Molly. Something I'm not sure that we ever did point out, there are trash cans in several places, which is awesome for picking up after your pet. So I don't know if you can tell, but down there on the left there's a trash can, and then there's one at almost every entrance. There's an entrance over here that I saw one, and then the entrance that we just came out of, and there's the pup and the husband. Mazel, how you doing?
She's doing great. Where's the ducks?
Good girl.
Our duck friends aren't here today.
Are our ducks not out?
You mentioned how you can film in stormwater.
Oh, that Molly is allowed?
Strong water.
In strong water. Yeah, the staff said that they were pretty sure every restaurant on Lowe's property is pet friendly. So we never did test that theory. We've walked around the lobby, sat in the lobby for breakfast, done a few things. But we never did try to take her to the bar. Maybe we should have.
I think one of my favorite architectural details is this. This is the, it effectively makes the whole building, the whole hotel, one building. It connects the main lobby, which is right there on the left. This glass hallway connects you to building two, which is where we stayed. And then it stretches all the way down there. The other thing I like about it over here is just the foliage. You have to like bend over to get through. It reinforces the whole tropical vibe, but yeah, I love coming out here in the mornings with Molly, listening to the waterfall. We're usually alone almost every single time. The pool, by the way, if you went up this pathway, you can get to it. You go right underneath that archway right there on the right, and you're in the pool. So just a little bit of wayfinding there. But we're going to miss this. The last day at a hotel always sucks. We did get a late checkout at noon. And now we're going to head to the lobby for some breakfast. Molly has been enjoying that. We did that the past couple days, so I'll meet you in the lobby. We're like magic. Now we are walking through that hallway I just pointed out. I was just down there making a commentary, and as I said, the pool is right on this side, so you can't miss it. But yeah, the hallway is really cool. That's the other thing I really like about this hotel is it really makes you come into the lobby to get everywhere.
Yeah, so not a bad way to start off your morning. You run into the Christmas tree, the television, and the main lobby. Yeah, again, not a bad place to have breakfast every morning. I mean, obviously, there's not a tree here all year long, but there is right now, so we're going to enjoy it. But just to give you another some more wayfinding in the lobby while we do a hotel tour here, there's Strong Water Tavern, the Rum Bar. Right next to it is kind of the main architectural feature, the stone stairway that goes down three levels. The second level would be the pool area, and then the first level is where the other restaurant is, and I'm blanking on the name. We'll walk by there in a little bit. And also the ferry boats to City Walk are down there too. But we're at the back end of the lobby. The other end, on the other far side there, that's where you'd actually walk in and check in if you're parking or doing valet or something like that. And then reception's on the right up here. Concierge is on the left. There's a gift shop. But yeah, just, I don't know. I love a big, beautiful, expansive lobby. I just love the way life comes together here. People coming and going and having drinks and reading books and chilling out and seeing old friends. It's just a hotbed of human activity, and it really doesn't matter what hotel you plot me in. I just love spending time in the lobby. My big complaint is that there's not a daytime bar here. It'd be nice to just chill out here and have a drink and read a book, but you'd have to go down to the pool bar to make that happen.
Molly loves a good lobby Christmas tree. Just chilling, just eating breakfast and people watching.
So I'm standing here at the valley drop-off for Sapphire Falls. This is where you'd come and do your check-in. But if you're doing self-parking, which was about $10 cheaper a night, I want to say it was $28, you'd go in right there. It's pretty easy. We parked on the second floor. We didn't have any problems. We got here on Thanksgiving Day, so that might not be the best example. But there seemed to be a lot of available parking. And just to situate you here, that is the Aventura Hotel. It basically shares the same turn court, and then off to the side here, that is the Cabana Bay Resort. That's actually across the street. But, if you wanted to make use of their restaurants and bars and lounges, I don't think you can use their amenities, but you can certainly use anything that you have to pay to use. You're free to rock over there at your leisure, or any other resort for that matter, as we did. So, yeah, kind of a gray day here, but a lovely pull-up. Let's go check out the main lobby. And your first dose of Christmas decorations is out here. They don't go overboard. Certainly the tree is nice, but they have nice touches here and there, and this is one of them. And this is what you're gonna find when you walk into the main lobby. It's nice grand entrance with a nice light feature that is not there for Christmas, that is always there. Reception is just off to your left. I never saw really long lines there. There is a luggage services. We made use of that upon check-in. Some guest rooms down there. And then just a lot of lounge space, a lot of workspace you can make use of. The Christmas tree is at the far end, but when you walk in, if you come over here to the right, you see a concierge desk over by the bricks there. But here is the obligatory Universal Studio store where you can get pretty much anything. I mean, they had all the good stuff in there. They had the Harry Potter, they had the Jurassic Park. They're obviously focusing on the Grinch right now for Christmas, but everything you need. And then there is the, it's not called concierge, it's a vacation planning center, but a very useful stop, I think, for a lot of people. The other useful location they have here in the lobby is the Dutch Trading Company. So it's just across from the gift shop. But you can get your coffee, you can get to-go breakfast in here, you can get coffee, sandwiches, pizza at night. Pretty much a short order stand. Donuts, chips, candy. Drinks. They're open until 11 o'clock, which is nice. Cereal. Pretty much anything you need outside of the gift shop. But yeah, they do these breakfast sandwiches here.
I can speak for the sausage and cheese. It's the bomb. And look, you can buy alcohol and breakfast sandwiches. Always a good combination. But they have salads, fruits, any kind of drink you'd want. The prices were pretty good. A huge cinnamon roll was only $5, so... And it was delicious, by the way. Highly recommend that. And look, they've even got ice cream over here. So this place has everything. This is definitely... We came here every day. This is very handy.
I think the coolest architectural feature in the lobby is this gigantic... I don't even know what you'd call it. Like a stone well, almost. But it gets really cool when you go inside. And this is basically your main mode of transportation to the other two floors. But look how cool it is in here. Look at this freaking chandelier. It just kind of cascades all the way down. Definitely one of the coolest focal points in the resort.
They're pushing up to the back of the lobby. There is the Christmas tree, which is beautiful. We've enjoyed breakfast here every single morning with Molly. There's just a couple steps down, and there's some couches down there, a big TV if you want to watch sports. But off to the right is somewhere we were frankly disappointed with. This is Strong Water Tavern. They don't open until 4. Problem number one, frankly. This place is awesome in terms of theming, the way it looks, comfort. I mean, look, it's huge. There's an outdoor patio, which you can see out there, that overlooks the lagoon. They have live music in here. You can bring your dogs in here. They make their own rum on site. They had some good TV. Everything about the service was amazing. The company was amazing. Everything was about this was great, except for the prices. And I want to say the caliber of the drinks. We spent $180 on rum, and it was like we were drinking, well, not even strong water, to put too fine a point on it. So, for $180, Amber and I like to get our money's worth, and we don't feel like we did. We would give this a second try, just based on how cool it is. But, I'd say that was kind of one of the biggest letdowns of the trip. Still, a beautiful place to sit. It really pops at night. You can see all the rum casts on the ceiling. I mean, they knocked it out of the park with theming. It's just, again, the goods has to be you know, the proof is in the pudding, and it wasn't here, so kind of a disappointment.
Well, it's kind of gloomy. It's actually warm enough to be in the water, and they definitely heat the pool water. Even on the coldest night, we were out here on, was it Thanksgiving night, Amber?
Yeah.
We were out here on Thanksgiving night, and it's probably 60, 59 degrees. And it was definitely more of a hot tub environment, but I went in the pool. It was nice. So there's the main slide out at the back there. Let's zoom in on that. Very cool. I did not go on the slide. I did not partake. There's a hot tub right next to it there. We spent a lot of time there. And the drum club bar, you can just see through the trees. But they really knock out of the park with the landscaping down there. There's a fire pit. There's plenty of seating. There's sand, not sand. They have an overflow bar when it gets too busy, and I can't imagine it does. I can't vouch for how hard it is to get a seat on a busy day. For Thanksgiving holiday, we had our pick of the litter. It just wasn't a problem. But yeah, this is the largest pool of any Universal Resort thus far, I think, even on the ones under construction. Definitely a showstopper for this place. We had a good time down here. This is probably my other favorite feature of the resort. This is the behind the Christmas tree and then the lobby here. The lagoon, the central lagoon. This is where the boats come to take you to City Walk. But look at this water feature. It's beautiful. And that's why I think this is the better view than a pool view. Well, we had a room down here. We couldn't really see the water feature. We had a nice view of the lagoon. And again, off to the side here, that is the terrace for Strong Water Tavern. Didn't go out there. We didn't see many people out there because it's just a little chilly and rainy while we were here. But that might make it worth a visit right there just to have that view and, you know, have a drink and enjoy all this. So. The setting here is spectacular. There's no doubt about it. I mean, look how beautiful this is. And there's all sorts, you know, I pointed it out when we took Molly up. There's all these little paths cut in there. And you can, little vantage points that you can find and explore. So, encourage you to do that. And you can take the lobby elevators down. Or you can take the staircase. This is the dramatic staircase I pointed out upstairs right on the other side of that wall. You come down to the first floor.
for the other restaurant on site here, which is called Amatista, right? Amatista. We did not eat here. I can't vouch for it. But people were saying the breakfast is pretty good. They're decked out for the holidays. They did a Thanksgiving buffet here, but it's cute. They certainly have good views. Looks like the breakfast spread's pretty good. So, yeah, maybe on our next trip we'll try this out. Yeah, nice view of the waterfall out there. And then, last but not least, right outside of Amatista is the door to the water taxi and the resort shuttle. So, you know, and there's more, you know, hallways to different wings of the guest rooms, but that's all it is guest rooms. But lots of seating down here, nice. More artwork. And there's the dramatic staircase. Amber had a good point. Look at this dessert venue. Maybe we should have eaten here. Like chocolate chip lava cake. I gotta say, that's probably gonna be better than the cheesecake I had at the Palm last night. But yeah, the menu is pretty good. They're not ranking it over the Coles too much. And there's the breakfast menu. Definitely, I'd say breakfast heavy here, which is great because that's my favorite meal. So when you come out of the main stone staircase on the second floor, you're gonna run into, on one side of the hallway, the Calypso game zone, which, you know, it's not as big as the Disney Resort arcades, but they've got the fundamentals in there. You wanna play some video games. And then on the other side, there's obviously, there's Beautiful Wife and Molly. There's the way of the pool, but then they also have the Kalina Health and Fitness Gym, which is pretty big. They got a lot of free weights in there. Looks like there's shower facilities. And it looks out over the swimming pool, so you have a pretty nice view while you're working out. So here's the pool from ground level, at least a portion of it. It's huge. It stretches way back. And then there's like a natural water feature. And that goes off into the waterfall that goes into the lagoon on the other side. There's my favorite class bridge. I love this bridge. That goes into the wing we stayed in. I think it's basically the pet wing. But you're not gonna drown here. There is plenty of lifeguards on duty. You do need a key to get into the pool. There's lots of cabanas with pretty good privacy. They have TVs in them. And there is poolside drink service. You can take your drinks into the pool, but you need to leave them on the edge. Like you can't wade into the center of the pool with them. Same with the hot tub. Not that you'd wanna do much waiting in the hot tub, but you can take your drinks in there, just stay by the edge of the hot tub. And it's raining on our day home, so I'm glad we didn't want to go swimming today. Here's another good shot of where the water taxi takes you. Downstairs, Amatista. You can see some outdoor seating down there. And then again, that's the terrace for Strong Water Tavern. Across the street, that's the Royal Pacific. Yeah. Great day in Orlando.
Molly. Hello, Molly. Molly is very sad. We're checking out. So I said when I did the room tour that we were going to leave the room a disaster. We don't leave anything a disaster. It's just messy. And it certainly doesn't look as good as it did at check-in. But it's our last view of the room. We're going to miss it. We had a great three nights here. I'll say this. I mentioned the water pressure in the shower. The water pressure was divine. Very good flow, and it's very comfortable in there. There's a nice seat in there, so yeah, there's no rain head, but you will be very comfortable and good products.
Well, guys, if you made it this far, I think you've just completed what is our longest video to date. So thank you so much for sticking around and joining our adventure. And again, for the disjointed nature of this video, it was a beast. I wasn't sure how to edit it, and you know, I think that some of our newness coming through, but hopefully you had a good time watching our adventure. Look, as always, we'd love to have you as a subscriber. Like, comment, share your experiences at this hotel or at the Universal Resort with us below. But above all, subscribe. I really want you guys to subscribe and share this channel with other like-minded people who you think would be a fan of the channel. And as always, have fun storming the castle and stay magical. See you next time.